On this episode, I want to show you how to create an adaptive card in Teams with data from ConnectWise. Now, to replicate this, it's very simple. We've gone through some of these other transactions in some of the other videos. So what I'm going to do is just step through nice and easy why and how for certain aspects. So as you can see here, we created a flow, scheduled flow, and that's why we have the reoccurrence here, that runs at 7:15 every 2 days. Nice and simple. Once we do that, we want to find out what time it is. And the reason we want to find out what time it is right now is so that we can pull from the custom connector, get opportunities on a certain time schedule, and show the value or the card in Teams. So as you can see here, we're going to get convert the UTC now from coordinated universal time to Eastern time. Wherever you are, that would work. I'm also going to use the short date pattern. After that, we're going to set three variables: salesperson, the script, variable script, and conditions. Now, when I say set variable, these are actually initialize variable features. So please make sure you use initialize variable. Down later, we will set the variables. But inside this var conditions, we are looking for open opportunities, and the expected close date is less than 10 days. So what we're doing is any open opportunities that are older than 10 days based on the expected close date, we are posting a card to Teams. So you can see here, and you can copy, add days, body, convert time zone, minus 10. Once we have the conditions, we can get the opportunities. This again, custom connector, if you need help building, there's another video, but we can also, you can reach out to Opal and we can assist. But here we can see we're pulling in just certain fields that we may or may not use all of them. But this is where we can show the data. Once we pull the data, that's when we want to use the body from the get opportunities and loop through. In this case, in its earlier video, or let's say blog, there was sending an email with all opportunities for a single person that was older than today. We merged those together. When we looked at the opportunities and wanting to update them older than 10 days, individualized, set them out so that we can have an individual separate card for each record. I know you can build cards other ways, and I will show you in just a second, but we can build other cards that have all the information and loop through. I wanted one card per in this situation. So once we're starting to loop through the body of the opportunities, we want to get the primary salesperson. So apply each, get salesperson ID. Then what we're going to utilize is the Microsoft get user profile, and this is the email or the name, which is actually the name, but it's email address. And then we're also going to get the person's principal name so that we can pull the photo as well. Once we have that, this is where we want to make sure we want to post an adaptive card in a chat or channel. Now the other option here is post the adaptive card in a chat or channel and wait for a response. We don't want to wait for the response at this point because we want them posted. What we're going to do is have a listener, a secondary listener that is waiting for the response, and I'll show you that in a second. It's a separate flow. If you put it as post adaptive card in chat and wait for response, very first one is going to post. We're going to wait until that one has been updated, then post the next one. Wait for that one, post the next one. It's not how you'd want, you want to post all of them at one time. So we're going to post as Flowbot to a channel. Our channel is called Traction, and it's our sales opportunity. Now this card, as you can see here, posted at adaptivecards.io.designer, it's going to have certain information. And what's going to happen is you're going to hit estimated close, put in a new date, click OK. Then it's going to patch back, and we'll show you that in a second. Like I said, there are other designers, and you can add them in here. We can have multiple. For this one, I kept it simple. But once I have that all set up, and I did actually include and replace the certain values. So the image, this is a dbase, base 64, and the output, that's going to convert the image. Down here, we want the display name. And then I've got a few other fields, and that's what you're going to see, the name, and then we've got fields here. Once this is all executed and done, again, save, push it out, and let it run. Now, what you're going to see in this here, let me pull this over, is in an adaptive card, you'll see this is what the adaptive card looks like. Overdue by 10 days. The following opportunity has been overdue by 10 days. Please update. I can click here, set a date to the 17th, hit OK. Now again, you'll notice in the flow, there was nothing to deal with the OK. So I hit the OK on this one, and now you can see it updated. Question is, how did it update? Separate flow. And that separate flow is, and I've labeled it ConnectWise response. This separate flow is from the teams, and it's when someone responds to an adaptive card. Now, what's very important is in the adaptive card, there is a card type ID. Now, if we go back, and I'm going to take a step back again. At the bottom of this here, we had show advanced options. And this show advanced option says ConnectWise, Teams opportunity, date, update. This is your card type ID. This is what the system is looking for. Now, there are articles out there saying it should be a more unique ID. I 100% agree. But for now, this is how it's currently set up. So we have a unique value that we are going to be referencing from the adaptive card response. So this is your input. This is actually, let me phrase it, this is almost like the output of the adaptive card. To get this information here, I will show you in just a second, but we have the ConnectWise card. To get this upper information, it's pretty simple. What you can do is go to one of your, go to your flow that you already have, click on one that ran, let's open this up, and in the output, we will get show raw output. Oh, hold on. So the output that you would get from the adaptive card is what you would want to paste into the upper part in here, the response. And you can see how I had a copy where it says sales rep's name, company name, etc. Once you have that, we want to, again, we want to do a time zone convert. And what this due date is the date that was changed. It's the date that the person put in. We want to make sure that we put it in the round trip date time pattern because this is what ConnectWise likes. We also taking it from Eastern and moving it to UTC time. Once we do that, we're using the custom connector and taking the ticket ID that we've pulled over and we're patching it. Converting time, which we just converted. And then once we've converted it, that's when we want to update the card to the new card, which doesn't have the button moving forward. Now, some of this information out there to get these fields pulled over into the card, again, we'd have to go back to the old one or the original. And I will admit there are some very good videos out there. I think the gentleman's name is Thomas. But it's really this body right here, this data section, becomes very important to move the data out. Now, I know I've gone through this fairly quickly. There's a lot of information. What I would recommend is testing, playing with it, trying things out. Obviously, you can see here we're using different functionality. We're using a custom connector for ConnectWise. We're using Teams to post, Microsoft to pull the person's email address along with photo. We are converting, we're using variables. When building this, it's important to understand that you can post the card and then you can have the response. That card type ID is going to be the key to wait for that response. Once you've all set this up, if you do have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out. We're more than willing to help. I hope this video can help generate some buzz on the adaptive cards. I was really excited about getting in and seeing the ConnectWise data in the adaptive card, so I wanted to make sure we posted it. This is a guy named Chris. Have a great day.